The room at the end of the corridor was closed off. It felt significant. Something terrible would happen there. I was both solving the crime and creating it. The prop room had been changed from room 104 to room 225. The troop were busy building their own Wicker Man, where they themselves would be sacrificed. The scene had changed. didn't have the key. Layers upon layers. A play about a murder cult, infiltrated by a real murder cult. The ballroom was where the pre-show ritual was held.
Thank you.
I couldn't add a new element from here. I'd have to go to the scene. My writing was affecting reality. I couldn't get in. I was missing something.
Night Springs. A special place, a shifting space, existing in a countless number of parallel realities. Sometimes a quaint small town, sometimes a hulking metropolis. Different every time we set upon the road that leads us there. And yet, like a half-remembered echo of a fading dream, always familiar to us. These are the stories that take place there. Awe-inspiring, macabre, terrifying, heartbreaking, nail-biting, absurd, and true. Sometimes all of these things at once. Night Spring.
This is where they gathered before the play. This is where it began. The details of the world. Another vision, another idea.
Why set up a play in a hotel? Why this hotel?
Because the rent is cheap? No. The ocean view was perfect for this. It's said to be haunted. Dark stories about murder, death, suicide. Supposedly, an actual cult once performed an unspeakable ritual to summon something in the ballroom. Did we summon the same thing? Tapped into something horrifying? It seemed like it was part of the play, but it wasn't. Does that sound crazy?
You don't want to ask me about crazy, kid.
A haunted hotel. Yes. That's a trope for a reason.
Wake.
The ballroom would be the stage of a key scene in the play. I recognized my writer's room on the stage. I almost dreaded the ideas this would conjure up.
What was the nice set you got here? What was the scene in this room?
Well, this is what we call the writer's room. In the play, it's where the devil rewrites reality whilst God is asleep. The devil was our star role. I got a big-time celebrity to play him, and he was method acting the role to perfection. He never broke character, always wore the cult mask. His name was scratched out on the posters.
Mm-hmm. And who was this mystery celebrity? Let me guess. Alan Wake?
I wish I could tell you. But turns out there were masks upon masks. Whoever he really was? Shit got weird when he was around. Some of the crew joked that we'd actually hired the devil to play himself.
Mr. Scratch is the devil. He was born to play the role.
I had to agree with Casey on that. This was dark, but the story had to be dark. Writing. This is Scratch mocking me. I needed to find the key. It could not be opened on the side. The scene changed with the story. This was not the ritual murder site I was looking for. This had just been an appetizer before the main course. Changing a plot element in a scene without being there was impossible.
Hey, Alan. How's the memory doing?
Sorry, who are you? Kidding. Good to see you, Tim.
You had me going.
Cozy place you got here.
You know, your disappearance from Bright Falls is still the only thing that folks talk about. Well, that and Deerfest. Is this where you ended up back in 2010?
You know about that?
I am the sheriff of Bright Falls. Or I was.
Are you related to Sarah Breaker? She was the sheriff of Bright Falls back in 2010.
Yeah, she's my cousin. I had a police sketch made of Dor based on my dreams. I sent it around and Sarah recognized the face from an old case file from the 80s. I moved out there to look into it and became sheriff after she left to join the feds.
So Deerfest is still a thing?
Oh yeah. Yeah, it's bigger than ever. You know, I got zapped here right before it was about to happen.
Funny, me too. What was in the case file about Dor?
Not a lot of details in it. A local man named Warland Dor went missing near Cauldron Lake. Eyewitnesses claim he was struck by a bolt of lightning and just vanished. I never found any official records of a Warland Dor living in town or anywhere. Another dead end.
I changed the story, and with that, the dark place changed.
All right. nothing left. I for a load.
The devil's path up the staircase was drained with blood. I felt the presence of a new idea here.
Mr. Scratch, if that's who the actor playing the devil was, had stayed in the hotel. Asking around at reception got me a room number. 666. He had requested that room, specifically. The devil had a sense of humor. Or he really didn't. It was funny either way. According to the director, the actor hadn't mingled with the rest of the cast. He had only come out for the play. And always in character.
Scratch had been there. I could sense his presence lingering in the room. I was about to have another killer idea.
Let's talk about the murder victim. The lady who was killed in the climax of the play.
The leading lady. Oh, it was an honor to get to work with her. A grand dame for sure. She went back a long time. Kept insisting she had seen the long-lost original script of the play. She'd been with this mysterious writer, his muse. That was her role in the play. The muse.
She was staying in room 108, where the murder happened.
The set of the final scene, right. The devil comes, an unstoppable force crashing through the hotel through each scene, executed with devastating mastery, and all leading up to him meeting his muse. It turns out he knew her. He had only joined the play to get to her.
To murder her.
Presence had come for me, drawn to the story I was writing as it grew darker.